Welcome to Audio Video System playlist. Here I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain public address system. And in this session I'll explain PA system in complete detail. So to understand this session based on PA system, these are my session outlines. So first I'm going to explain basics of PA system, and then after I'll be covering block diagram of PA system. Then we will see mixture of PA system, and gradually I'll explain all the components which is there in PA system step by step. And then we will see requirements of PA system, and then I'll show some installation of PA system which is there in different public address system. So these are my session outlines. Let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of PA system. Now see, intensity of sound that decreases with the distance. So at nearer by the person, sound intensity will be maximum, and as it goes further, you'll be finding with respect to distance, intensity of sound will decrease. So in large gathering, there will be a need of amplification for comfortable listening. Like see, here you can see one auditorium is there, where this is a stage. And if you see this distance, then this distance that is there in terms of
100 to 200 right. meters.
So right. whenever if somebody is addressing this gathering from here, you'll be finding there is a need of large amplification. The reason is when this person is speaking from here, that distance cannot propagate to the last bench which is over here, right? So ultimately here there is a need of amplification for comfortable listening. There are so many other things even that is required, so that we will see step by step. See, for better understanding, sound quality is very important. So here, by using PA system, we will provide such sound system in this entire auditorium so that we can provide good sound quality to each and every audience which is sitting in this auditorium. So PA system is used to improve sound quality in big structures, and it is used in sports meet, it could be used in public meetings, in auditorium, concerts, and in functions we can use PA system. We will see detailed understanding of all those things in this particular video lecture, so that it will be more clear how we can use this PA system, where we should be using it, and how this PA system is getting operated. So first we need to understand what is PA system. So for that, let us have a block diagram of PA system first. So in PA system, first we have a mic, and this mic that is translating sound signal into electrical signal. So here if somebody is speaking, that sound signal that will get translated into electrical signal. Here one can see multiple mics are there, means multiple channels are there. And those multiple channels, that is first connected in mixer, then after that is connected in voltage amplifier, then it is connected with process circuit, then after it will be connected with driver amplifier, and then it will be connected with power amplifier, and at the end it will be given to loudspeaker. So this is the basic block diagram which is there in PA system. And in that, first we have a mic that will translate audio signal into electrical signal. So here multiple mics that one can see. So multiple channels are connected with mixer. Now we will see this entire block diagram step by step with each and every element. So first I'll explain you mixer. So here let us see what is mixer in PA system. So one can see one mixer diagram that I have placed here, where as I have told you, there could be multiple mics, so there could be multiple channels. So here one channel that is shown over here, likewise there could be so many other channels, so you can see it over here, right? multiple channels are there. Vertically, channel is there. Output of microphone that will be given to the mixer. And it is used to isolate from different channel from each other before we feed it to main amplifier. So we need to isolate different channels and then we need to feed it to main amplifier. If you cannot isolate channels, then those channels will cancel sound from each other. So it is so essential to isolate channels from each other, and that task is been done by mixer. It can be built in or there could be separate pluggable unit. This is what separate pluggable unit, but in some PA system you will be finding there is built in mixer which is there with PA system, but it could be separate pluggable mixer which is there with PA system. That depends on the requirement, what type of PA system that we need to have. In big auditorium or in big concerts we need this separate mixer, right? But in small functions like in hall of dimensions of 10 meter cross 10 meter, in that case you can have normal PA system without having separate mixer. Now when we talk about mixer, basically there are three types of mixers. If I say simplest one, so that simplest one does not have preamplifiers as well as amplifier. It has only gain control and isolating series resistors. So when I'll show you the basic circuit of it, at that time it will be more clear. But one should know, simplest mixer does not have preamplifier and amplifiers. It has only gain control and isolating series resistors. Little sophisticated mixer that is having common preamplifier after isolating resistors. So when we talk about little sophisticated mixer, at a time there will be common preamplifier for all channels. And when we talk about most sophisticated mixer, in that case there will be separate preamplifier for separate channels. So that you will be getting after the basic circuit which is there with mixer. So let us have a circuit of mixer so it will be more clear. Now see, here one can see there are input terminals. So there are different mics. So there are different input from mics. So here 5 inputs that I have shown, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now after that I have connected resistor gain control, you can see. So this is what one can say rheostat. So P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, these rheostats will control gain of different inputs, right? And after that I have connected common preamplifier. So this is what little sophisticated mixer. In simple mixer you don't need this preamplifier. In little sophisticated mixer, this preamplifier that will be common for all. And in sophisticated mixer, you will be having preamplifier for individual channels, right? So this is what the basic circuit that will be there with mixer. Now we will see all the blocks step by step. So after mixer, we have voltage amplifier which is connected in the circuit. So whatever output that is there with this mixer, that is connected to voltage amplifier. And this voltage amplifier that amplifies output of mixer. So here at output of voltage amplifier, there will be higher voltage, which is what we have it from output of mixer. So output of voltage amplifier will be amplifying output of mixer. Then after, we connect processing circuits. So in processing circuits, you'll be finding there will be a circuit which has master gain control and tone controls. So there are two controls that is so essential. In master gain control, you'll be having resultant gain of entire audio signal. And in tone control gains, you will be having control of bars and terrible control. So processing circuit is providing this control mechanism, master gain control and tone controls. And after that, we use driver amplifier. So you'll be finding after processing circuit, we have driver amplifier. Now see, this driver amplifier is so essential. It gives voltage amplification to the signal to such extent that when we feed this to next stage, internal resistance of this stage is reduced. So internal resistance that will get reduced by this so that it can drive power amplifier to give more power. So ultimately here we will be connecting power amplifier, which will be next stage of this. And task of this driver amplifier is to amplify the signal as well as it will reduce internal resistance. And because of that, we can drive more power by using power amplifier in further block. So this is the basic task which is there with driver amplifier. So next, that will be power amplifier. And when we talk about power amplifier, obviously it has been there to provide power amplification. And in that you'll be finding push-pull type of circuit is used in general, so that it will be eliminating harmonics. In push-pull type, you'll be finding harmonics are getting eliminated. And as harmonics are getting eliminated, transformer core does not get saturated. Why? The reason is when you connect further block, that is sound speaker over here, that sound speaker is connected via matching transformer. So if there is harmonics, in that case, transformer core will get saturated, and we don't need to saturate transformer core when we connect this power amplifier with loudspeaker. So if we use push-pull type network, in that case harmonics are getting eliminated and transformer core will not get saturated. Output of power amplifier is connected to loudspeaker through matching transformer. So next, last block, that will be loudspeaker. And in loudspeaker, you will be finding it will be generating sound by having pressure vibrations from electrical input. So here there will be electrical input, and here you'll be finding there will be sound. So this is what the basic block diagram, which is there in PA system. Now we will see the basic requirements, which is there with PA system, and this is so essential. So we will see all those things step by step, so it will be more clear to you. See, acoustic feedback. So whenever we talk about PA system, there should not be feedback of loudspeaker to the microphone. So acoustic feedback should not be there. So microphone should get isolated from the sound of loudspeaker. So this is what we need to keep in our mind. Now next is distribution of sound intensity. See, whenever you have any public address system, distribution of sound intensity should be uniform in entire area. Like see, if you have a seminar hall over here, and here there is a stage, and we have different audience over here. So distribution of sound, that should be uniform. And this is what we need to have it by having PA system over here. So that we can optimize by using multiple speaker rather to use single speaker. Like see, if you use two power speaker over here, then sound intensity will be higher over here and it will be lower at the end. So nearer people will feel more sound intensity, right? And far people, that will be having lower sound intensity. So instead of that, if you distribute sound by using multiple speakers, then you can have proper distribution of sound intensity. So we will see that in different PA system, so it will be more clear. Now see, next is reverberation. See, this is happening because of overlapping of successive sound waves. So when you have two speakers and their sound is overlapping to each other, it may generate reverberation. So PA system should be throwing additional power in those areas where direct sound gets submerged in the echoes. So whenever there will be a reverberation in some spots, we should have some speaker which is throwing additional sound. so that we can remove this reverberation. So this is what we need to identify based on what type of area in which we need to apply PA system. So we will see different PA system, so it will be more clear. Now see, orientation of loudspeaker, that is very essential part of PA system. So we need to have orientation of loudspeaker in such a way that we can distribute sound uniformly in entire region. Now see, ambient noise. So ambient noise that is very high in sports event, like see, if you have football stadium, in that case you'll be finding ambient noise is very high. So in that case, public address system should boost high frequencies, and as if you boost high frequencies, in that case we can nullify up to some extent, we can nullify this ambient noise up to some extent. And in high noise environment, amplification also kept high, and that is what we need to do to have removal of ambient noise. So there are so many other things even that we need to focus about, like what should be the position of microphone and so many other things even. But ambient noise that we can eliminate, we cannot eliminate, but we can say we can have good public address system so that we can fill less ambient noise, like in football stadium, too much noise is there because of audience. So where we can have less ambient noise by boosting high frequencies, or we can amplify signal. Now next is dynamic range limitation. The amplifier of good public address system equipped with level limiter, which keeps output level constant when input level exceeds, and you will be finding there will be some issues because of this dynamic range. Like see, if you have a person who is speaking from here, and if that person is having microphone which is nearer to the mouth of this person, in that case there will be more sound which is entering in the mic. And if person is moving its position, in that case you'll be finding due to larger distance with respect to mic, signal will be less which is there in mic. So public address system that should be such that you should be amplifying as well as you should be attenuating signal as and when it is required. So this is what we can have it by having level limiter. Now next is selection of microphone. So it is so essential even. As I have told you, microphone should be isolated from the sound of loudspeaker. So you can use cardioid type like microphone which will neither pick up reflected sound from loudspeaker. And on dramas you will be finding you need such microphone which should be getting isolated from the loudspeaker. So there are some microphones which we have already discussed, so out of those microphones you can select. Sense of the direction from the source of sound. So loudspeaker should be placed in such a way so that sound appears to be coming from the direction of the source only. So sense of the direction of source of sound, that is so essential, so that human can feel like from that direction only sound is coming. So for that we need to understand one thing: human ears perceives the direction from the first sound receives. So whenever you have multiple speakers, you need to place that in such a way that sound should be sense in the direction from where source is generating the sound. So that is what the main task which is there with public address system. Now next is phase delay. Now see, in phase delay you will be finding sound from the nearest loudspeaker may be heard along with the sound from the loudspeaker which is there at some other distance, right? So you will be finding there will be phase delay in between two sounds. So we need to see here what is the distance in between loudspeaker. So here we need to keep one thing in our mind: loudspeaker distance should not be greater than 16 meters. There should be a separation of 10 meters right? So ideal distance in between two loudspeaker is 10 meter, and you should not exceed to more than 16 meter. Otherwise, it will start to provide some issues of phase delay. So that is always happens as if you keep distance in between loudspeaker too high. Next is matching. So impedance matching is so essential. We should have proper impedance matching from power amplifier to loudspeaker so that it can transfer maximum power. So that is so essential in public address system. Next is grounding. See, chassis and shields of equipment and coaxial cable should be properly earthed through the water pipe. Otherwise, there will be a noise. So grounding is so essential in PA system. Proper earthing should be provided, in short. Amplifier power. So that is so essential. There are, for different public address system, different amplification is required. So that is based on what type of network that we need to establish. Like for class lectures, there is a need of few watts of amplification, while in large gathering, it could be in terms of hundreds of watts. So that is based on what type of gathering that we have. For small gathering, it will be having need of lower amplification, and for large gathering, there will be a need of higher amplification. Choice of loudspeaker, so that is even so essential. So based on size of public addressing, we need to have choice of loudspeaker. And you'll be finding when high fidelity is required, speaker column contains woofer, squawkers, tweeter, right? And for higher efficiency, we should go for horn type loudspeaker, and for lower efficiency, we should go for conch type loudspeaker. So there are different loudspeaker which we have already seen. So based on the requirement, we should select loudspeaker. See, close ring connection of loudspeaker, that is so essential. Why? The reason is, for better reliability, loudspeaker should be connected in closed ring. So that what happens is, like, if any loudspeaker is getting failed, it should not disturb to entire chain. So for that, it is so essential to have closed ring connection. So if any loudspeaker is getting failed, it will not affect to other speakers. So closed ring connection is so essential. In open ring connection, there could be some other issues, but it is preferred to have closed ring connection of loudspeaker. Now see AC hum. So AC hum, that is been picked up by microphone. So microphone leads can pick up hum of AC main wire. Hence microphone lead should be as short as possible. So see, basically AC hum, that is been picked up by leads of microphone. And if you keep microphone lead shorter, in that case, it will pick up less AC hum. So this is what we need to keep in our mind. And if long leads are there, in that case, we need to have some other precautions. So usually you will be finding less length of leads are there with microphone. And even you'll be finding that absorber is covered with microphone. So my absorber is covered with the microphone because of AC hum issues. Placement of microphones is so essential. So I'll show you some installation of public address system. So it will give you idea about placement of microphone, how to place it. RF pickup. See, RF pickup, that is happening because of poor grounding, and RF noise that may generate unwanted sound in loudspeaker. So we can reduce RF noise by connecting RF bypass capacitor at amplifier. So usually you'll be finding RF bypass capacitor that is connected at amplifier side to remove that RF noise. And presence of PA system should not be felt. So we should be placing PA system in such a way, this presence of PA system, that should not get felt. So let us see public meeting, public address system. So in public meeting PA system, see here there is a stage and speakers are distributed in such a way there will be uniform sound distribution in this public region, right? So this is the region which we are a little bit to cover about, and in this region we have kept this speaker in such a way there will be uniform sound intensity which is happening with this public meeting. Now in auditorium you'll be finding, see this is a stage and these are power speaker. So this power speaker that is having higher power handling capability and these are low power speaker which is connected in this auditorium. So from this stage side you'll be finding this power speaker is radiating sound with higher intensity, and this stage is structured in such a way the sound which is generated by the speakers will not reaches to microphone which is over here, right? So this type of arrangement is been made in auditorium. Now see in debating hall, you can see these are the position of debaters and each seat is having microphone. Now whenever they are debating, they can listen to each other by this low power speaker. And here there is a public gallery. So this public gallery can listen sound by this high power speaker. Right. So this is how arrangement is there. Now in football stadium, you can see speakers are connected like this with this direction. Right. So here there will be audience and this audience can listen sound commentary by this speaker, and this sound is not going towards players, those who are playing on this field over here. So this is where they are playing on the ground. So they should not fill the commentary with larger sound, and this commentary is going towards public. They are listening, they are watching this game, right?
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions which is highly required here to optimize this.